Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. Here we will be discussing problems based on Jordan canonical form. Right, so let us look at the first problem. So determine all the possible Jordan canonical forms J for a linear operator whose characteristic polynomial is this and whose minimal polynomial is this. So you have an operator whose characteristic polynomial is this and minimal polynomial is this. So here you can clearly see that both the characteristic and the minimal polynomial, they are factorized into linear factors, then for sure you can write the Jordan canonical form. So you have to see what will be the Jordan canonical form. Now you see here the characteristic polynomial is of degree 5, right? Characteristic polynomial is of degree 5, therefore the final matrix is, it means that your matrix is of size 5 cross 5. So the Jordan canonical form will be of size 5 cross 5. And also in the minimal polynomial you see there is t minus 2 raised to power 2. It means that the maximum size of the Jordan block will be 2. All other blocks will be of size less than is equal to 2. Fine. So 2 is the only eigenvalue. So it means that, and this is one more observation, because 2 is the only eigenvalue, so all the diagonal entries must be 2 in the Jordan canonical form. And then because exponent in the minimal polynomial is 2 of t minus 2, so t must have one Jordan block of size 2, at least one Jordan block is of size 2 for sure, and all others will be of size either 1 or 2. So it means that you can have one, the possibility, you can have two blocks of size 2 and one block of size 1, fine, and then you can have, you can just commute, you can have size 2 block here, size 2 block here, and size 1 block here. And then you can also have one block of size 2 and all other blocks of size 1. You cannot have all the blocks of size 1 because there must be at least one block of size 2 for sure. So these are the possible Jordan canonical forms. So it means that you can choose different bases. With respect to one basis, it will have this representation. With respect to some other basis, this will have this representation. And with respect to some other basis, this will have this representation. Is that okay? So these are the all possible Jordan canonical form for a linear transformation whose characteristic polynomial looks like this and the minimal polynomial looks like this. Right? So let us see next question. Determine all the possible Jordan canonical forms for a linear operator whose characteristic polynomial is given. Only the characteristic polynomial is given. Fine. So let us see what are the observations. First of all, the polynomial, characteristic polynomial is of degree 5. Therefore, J is of size 5 cross 5. First thing is, J is of size 5 cross 5. And then since the exponent t minus 2, exponent of t minus 2 is 3 and exponent of t minus 5 is 2, it means that the 2 will appear 3 times and 5 will appear 2 times on the diagonal. Okay, so 2 must appear 3 times and 5 must appear 2 times. Now because this only the characteristic polynomial cannot decide your Jordan canonical form, so you have to see what are the possible choices for minimal polynomial. Now we know that characteristic and minimal polynomial, they have the same factors. Now corresponding to this characteristic polynomial, you can have this choice of minimal polynomial. It means that characteristic polynomial is same as minimal polynomial. So this is the first choice of minimal polynomial. So I have listed all the possible choices of minimal polynomial. You can have this choice of minimal polynomial, t minus 5, t minus 2 raised to power 3. Or you can reduce this power by 1 and then you can have this reduced by 1, or you can reduce this power by 2 and then you reduce this by 1. So this is because you cannot have that there is a factor t minus 5 in the characteristic polynomial but it is not there in minimal polynomial. It is not possible because we have already proved the theorem that characteristic and minimal polynomials, they have the same linear factors. So these are the only choices for minimal polynomial. So you have total 6 choices for minimal polynomial. So let us see, when you have the first choice of minimal polynomial, m1 mt is this, t minus 2 cube, t minus 2, 5 raised to power 2. Now let us see, from here you are saying that there should be exactly one block of size 3 because 2 can appear 3 times only on the diagonal. And in the minimal polynomial, the exponent is 3. It means that there is exactly one block of size 3. And similarly, there is exactly one block of size 2 for 5s. So your Jordan canonical form looks like this. One block of size 3, one block of size 2. Right? So how you will make your block? 2, 2, 2 on the diagonal, 1, 1 on the super diagonal, and 0 everywhere else. And how you will make this block? 5, 5 on the diagonal, 1 on the super diagonal, 0 everywhere else. So corresponding to this minimal polynomial, this is the Jordan canonical form. Now let us look at the second choice of minimal polynomial, which is t minus 2 cube, t minus 5 raised to power 1. So now again, because 2 can appear only thrice on the diagonal, so there will be exactly one block of size 3 with 2s on the diagonal. And because this exponent is 1, it means that with 5, the maximum size of the block is 1. It means that, and 5 has to appear 2 times. It means that there will be 2 blocks of size 1 for 5. So you see, this is one block of size 3 by 3 for the eigenvalue 2. It means that 2, 2, 2 on the diagonal, 1, 1 on the super diagonal. Now this is the 1 cross 1 block for 5, and this is another 1 cross 1 block for 5. So this is the Jordan canonical form. Fine. Now let us look at the next choice of the minimal polynomial. Here you have t minus 2 square, t minus 5 square. Now you see, 2 has to appear thrice on the diagonal because that is its algebraic multiplicity. And here the exponent is 2. It means that the maximum block size is 2, and there should be at least one block of size 2. It means that we will have one block of size 2 and one block of size 1 corresponding to 2. So you have one block of size 2 and one block of size 1. And then similarly, 5 has to appear twice on the diagonal because its algebraic multiplicity is 2. And then the exponent is also 2. So there is at least one block of size 2. Right? So it means that there is exactly one block of size 2. So this is the corresponding Jordan canonical form. Obviously, you can reshift. You can sometimes bring it here and bring it here. So that combinations are possible, but that is not important, because this is the canonical form, right? Okay, so now let us look at the next choice of the minimal polynomial, which is t minus 2 square, t minus 5. Now again, you see, 2 has to appear thrice on the diagonal, so there is exponent of t minus 2 in the minimal polynomial is 2. Therefore, there is exactly one block of size 2. There is exactly one block of size 2 and one block of size 1. Now because t minus 5 raised to power 1, so the block can be of size 1, and 5 has to appear twice. So therefore, 2 blocks of size 1 for lambda equal to 5. So this is for lambda equal to 2. So how our canonical form will look? So we have to make exactly one block of size 2. Right? Why exactly? Because we have a total possibility of 3, 2 plus 1, right? And there should be a block of size 2 for sure. So it is 2, 2, 1, 0. This is a block of size 2. Then you have to have a block of size 1. Then you have to have two blocks of size 1. Right? So this is your Jordan canonical form. Everywhere else you will write zeros. You get it? This is how you write your Jordan canonical form. Now let us look at the next choice of the minimal polynomial. Mt is equal to t minus 2, t minus 5 square. Now again, this is 1. It means that corresponding to lambda equal to 2, blocks are of size 1. And there 2, and also 2 has to appear thrice. Therefore, total 3 blocks. And because the exponent is 2 here, so corresponding to 5, there is at least for sure one block of size 2 cross 2. And 5 has to appear twice on the diagonal because its algebraic multiplicity is 2, that we see from the characteristic polynomial. Therefore, we have 3 blocks of size 1 cross 1 corresponding to lambda equal to 2. And we have one block of size 2 cross 2 corresponding to lambda equal to 5. So our Jordan canonical form looks like 2, 2, 2, then you have 5, 5, 1, right, 0. So these are your this is your Jordan canonical form, right? So you have to put zeros everywhere else. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Then you have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is the required Jordan canonical form. Now next, you let us look at the last choice of minimal polynomial. It was mt is equal to t minus 2, t minus 5. Now you see, here you have the exponent in the minimal polynomial is 1. It means that all the blocks will be of size 1. And 2 has to appear thrice. 5 has to appear twice. So you will just write like this. 2, 2, 2, 5, 5. So these are of size 1. So blocks are of size 1. So everywhere else you have zeros. Okay, everywhere else you have zeros. So this is the Jordan canonical form. So you should understand that every diagonal form is also a Jordan canonical form, where each block is of size 1 cross 1. So you see, this is how you write the Jordan canonical forms. Okay, so we can do one last problem, because more you practice, more you will have understanding of what is happening. Write the Jordan canonical form for a matrix whose minimal polynomial and the characteristic polynomial. This is the characteristic polynomial is t minus 2 raised to power 4, t minus 5 raised to power 3, and minimal polynomial is t minus 2 raised to power 2, t minus 5 raised to power 3. Now you see here, from here you will, what you will do, first you will look at your characteristic polynomial. You see the order is 7 cross 7. So your final matrix will be 7 cross 7. 2 has to appear 4 times and 5 has to appear 3 times. Corresponding to 2, the maximum block size is 2. Corresponding to 2, maximum block size is 2. So it means that you can have, and total 4 times it should appear. So you have choices, 2 blocks, 2 cross 2 each. Or you can have 1 block, 2 cross 2, and 2 blocks, 1 cross 1. Right? But you cannot have other option, because for sure there is 1 block of size 2 cross 2. Okay? So these are the 2 choices. And corresponding to 5, for lambda equal to 5, the exponent here is 3 and here also it is 3. So there is only one choice, that one block of size 3 cross 3. So what are the possible JCFs, Jordan canonical form? So corresponding to here, you have 2 blocks of size 2. So you have 2, 2, 1. This is one block of size 2. 2, 1, 0, 2. This is another block of size 2. And then you have one block of size 3. So you have 5, 5, 5, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so this is one JCF. Everywhere else you have zeros. I hope you understand how you write the JCFs for a given matrix. Right? Okay, now for the other choice, where you have this one block of 2 cross 2, two blocks of 1 cross 1, and then 1 block of 3 cross 3. So you have 2, 1, 0, 2. This is a block of size 2 cross 2. Then you have 2 blocks of size 1 each. And then at the end you have 1 block of size 3. 1, 5, 1, 0, 0, 5, 0, 1, 0, 0, 5. So this is your JCF, right? So this is how you can write the JCF for a given matrix. Thank you for watching. Please share this video and subscribe to this channel.